Bonjour, bonjour. Comment ça va? Tavy here from French Speak. Bienvenue. Today, I'm going to teach you all the ways to say the word suit. I've been asked three times in one week, so I thought I better give a comprehensive list and answer. So we're going to work on your French vocabulary today. Allez, commençons. Alors, the first one we are going to see is le maillot de bain. Not the easiest one to pronounce, le maillot de bain. So make sure you split the A, ma, and then say the yo separately. Le maillot de bain. Ensuite, nous avons le body. We just took the English words, and like a lot of them, the gender becomes masculine. Le body, or un body. Ensuite, nous avons le bleu de travail. Le bleu de travail. Pour le costume classique, il y a plusieurs noms. For the word suit itself, man suit, we do have several words. Le costume, le costard cravate, or the shortened version, le costard. A little more informal. Le costume, le costard cravate, le costard. For ladies, we wear le tailleur. Again, remember not to say a with this AI because the I belongs to the double L. So ILL makes us do that y sound. So we just say ta, ta, and then yeur. Le tailleur, le tailleur. Ensuite, pour faire de l'exercice, pour faire du sport, le jogging ou le survêtement. And we do sometimes shorten it and just say survêt. So we have le jogging, le survêtement ou le survêt. Ici, c'est un ou le costume décontracté. Décontracté means laid back, relaxed. So this type of suit we will call un ou le costume décontracté. This type of suit will be la tenue de cowboy. Again, we've taken an English word and we pronounce it the French way. La tenue de cowboy. Literally, the outfit of cowboys. La tenue de cowboy. Ensuite, a diving or wetsuit, ça s'appelle la combinaison de plongée. La combinaison de plongée. Combinaison. La combinaison de plongée. Pour a dress suit, c'est une tenue de soirée. La tenue de soirée. A dry suit is called la combinaison étanche. La combinaison étanche. Étanche is a word you can see for anything that doesn't let water in. La combinaison étanche. Keeps you dry. The suit jacket is la veste de costume. La veste de costume. And then we have this part here, which is, does not have the word suit in it, but I thought I should add it in. It's called la cravate. La cravate. If you're wearing a bow tie, not just a tie, this should say a bow tie in the red font, le nœud pap. Sometimes shortened, le nœud pap or le nœud papillon, because it looks like a butterfly, un papillon. Le nœud papillon. Don't overthink all the letters in the word nœud, it means knot. You also have a silent letter, K, in the word not. We have lots of silent letters. Just pronounce ne, like when you say N-E, ne. safari suit would be la tenue de safari. I really hope I covered all bases here. For suit, la tenue de safari. And a sailor suit can be l'uniforme de marin. L'uniforme de marin. Make sure you do a beautiful nasal N for marin. So you can't even hear the letter N. Marin. Or it'll be called le costume marin. Le costume marin. A shell suit back in the 80s. Le survêtement. And if you're really wanting to separate that style, it'll be coloré, colorful, en nylon. Le survêtement coloré en nylon, specifically this very, very trendy outfit. A ski suit would be la combinaison de ski. La combinaison de ski. And often we do shorten combi, just for combinaison, la combi de ski ou la combinaison de ski. We have a few more. Le smoking would be a tuxedo. Le smoking, such a strange name for it, but just think of a cigar room with men dressed in tux and smoking cigars. Le smoking, le smoking. Here we have en pingouin, which is the informal, funny way we describe someone wearing a tux is en pingouin. Il est habillé en pingouin, or just il est en pingouin, based on the animal, the penguin. Et finalement, in your birthday suit, I had to add that one. In your birthday suit is nu or à poil. Il ou elle est nu. That would be a neutral way to say it. And à poil would be the familiar way to say it. So be careful of your audience when you say that one. Voilà. There are all the ways you can say the word suit or something suit for different types. We did underwater, safari, and different types of uniforms in there. So I'm hoping that you've gathered a few new words along the way. À la prochaine!